Good afternoon, students. So today we are going to learn about periodic table chapter 13. So now you may wonder in the teacher pattern chapter 13 lo to poyidunna because nammal ippo chapter 2nd a padichathu. So adinte continuation enna nilaiki chapter 13 aanu most apt. Appo idu appo oru finishing kittum allengi namaku aa oru ippo padichayinde angane oru base sick things ഒക്കെ നമുക്ക് സെക്കൻഡ് ചാപ്റ്ററിൽ ഉണ്ട് സോ 13th ചാപ്റ്റർ ഇപ്പോ തന്നെ എടുത്താൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കുറച്ചും കൂടി ഈസി ആയിട്ട് മനസ്സിലാവും അതുകൊണ്ടാണ് ഞാൻ ഇപ്പോ തന്നെ 13th ചാപ്റ്റർ എടുക്കുന്നത് ഓക്കേ സോ ഇൻ ദിസ് ചാപ്റ്റർ വി വിൽ ഡിസ്കസ് അബൌട്ട് ഹൗ ദി എലമെന്റ്സ് ആർ ഓർഗനൈസ്ഡ് ഇൻടു ടേബിൾ ഓഫ് പീരിയഡ്സ് ആൻഡ് ഗ്രൂപ്പ്സ് ബേസ്ഡ് ഓൺ ദി ഓർഡർ ഓഫ് ഇൻക്രീസിംഗ് ആറ്റോമിക് നമ്പർ okay and describe the relationship between the group number and the ionic charge of the element and explain the similarities in the chemical properties of the element in a group and describe the trends in the properties of group 1 alkali metals and describe the trends in the properties of halogens and describe the noble gas and unreactive monoatomic gas describe the changes from metallic to non-metallic character across a period and describe key characteristics of transition elements and identify the trends adukku nammal padikkum so make an estimate of how many more metals there are than non metals and where they are placed in the periodic table namukku arayam metals are placed in the left hand side of the periodic table and what are the properties you most obviously associate with the metals when namukku discuss cheyan pattunna major properties are metals are conductive right metals are conductive they are shiny they are malleable ductile so ingen sonorous alle ingen the properties malleable nu parney malleable means it can be made to thin sheets ductile means it can be drawn to thin wire so idakkeyana namukku metals ne ariyavunna properties okay discuss the question all are all metals magnetic alle metals in a magnetic property inda ella metals in a magnetic undo choicha illa some of the metals are non magnetic metals so adu namaku koodalayittu padikkanund so if you have a magnet try to use of samples of aluminum copper and magnesium can you name three most magnetic and magnetic elements adayathu ipo namaku arayam iron ennu parayunnathu magnetic aanu so appo avade namaku ella metals magnetic aano ennu choicha that's a big question so namaku adu and pinneedu discuss cheyam okay so next we are going for the introduction section that is woman behind the periodic table ഈ ഒരു ഇൻട്രൊഡക്ഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് നമ്മുടെ ഈ ലെസണുമായിട്ട് അധികം റിലേഷൻ ഒന്നുമില്ല ബിക്കോസ് ഇതിൽ കുറച്ച് ഭാഗം പറയുന്നുണ്ട് അതായത് ഹിസ്റ്ററി ഓഫ് പീരിയോഡിക് ടേബിളിന്റെ കുറച്ച് ഭാഗം പറയുന്നുണ്ട് പക്ഷെ കൂടുതലായിട്ട് ഈ ജെൻഡർ ഇക്വാലിറ്റി അതായത് ഇപ്പോ ഈവൻ ഫോർ സയന്റിഫിക് റിസർച്ച് മെയിൽ പ്രോമിനൻസ് ആണ് കൂടുതൽ വരുന്നത് ഫീമെയിൽ ഫീമെയിൽസിന്റെ ഇൻവെൻഷൻസ് ഒന്നും അധികം ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ടായിരുന്നില്ല ആ കാലഘട്ടത്തും ആൻഡ് ഇൻ ദ പ്രസന്റ് സെഞ്ചുറി ഓൾസോ Female participation is not that much given importance in the scientific research field. So we have to change our observation and we have to change our vision also in this particular section. That is gender equality. അതായത് ഏത് ഫീൽഡിലാണെങ്കിലും both male and female should get equal importance. അല്ലെ So the modern periodic table has a major scientific achievement involving both men and women. So ഇപ്പോ നമ്മൾ കാണുന്ന present modern periodic table എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് mostly periodic table ആണ് MOSSLEY mostly periodic table ആണ് ഇന്ന് നമ്മൾ യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്ന periodic table. ഇതിനു മുമ്പ് ഏറ്റവും സക്സസ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള periodic table എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് മെൻഡലീവിന്റെ periodic table ആണ് So the breakthrough in the organization of elements came in 1869 when the Russian chemist Dmitry Ivanovich Mendeleev put forward his idea of periodic table. In his attempt, he used 32 of 61 elements known at that time and stressed the idea there was a periodic pattern of properties and of elements. Alle, adayathu ipo namukku ariyam sodium ipo first group ilulla elements enna consider cheyyam. Adayathu lithium adeyna sodium adeyna potassium. Idu varunnathinokke adayathu similar group ile varunnathinokke ore എന്തുണ്ട് പ്രോപ്പർട്ടീസ് റിപ്പീറ്റഡ് ആണ്. അതായത് ഇറ്റ് ക്യാൻ ഇപ്പോൾ സോഡിയം എടുത്താലും ലിത്യം എടുത്താലും പൊട്ടാഷ്യം എടുത്താലും ഇറ്റ് ക്യാൻ ഡൊണേറ്റ് വൺ ഇലക്ട്രോൺസ്. അതപ്പോൾ അതിന്റെ കെമിക്കൽ റിയാക്ടിവിറ്റി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് സെയിം ആയിരിക്കും. സോ ഇങ്ങനത്തെ കുറെ കാര്യങ്ങൾ, അതായത് ഇത് പീരിയോഡിക്കലി, അതായത് ആഫ്റ്റർ ദിസ് പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ ആഫ്റ്റർ ഒരു പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ സെക്ഷൻസ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ആഫ്റ്റർ എ പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ പീരീഡ് ദ പ്രോപ്പർട്ടീസ് ആർ റിപ്പീറ്റിംഗ് എന്നുള്ളത് മെന്റലി ആദ്യം തന്നെ സ്റ്റേറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് വെച്ചിട്ടുണ്ടായിരുന്നു. സോ മെന്റലി ഡ്രൂ ഓൺ ഹിസ് ദ ടേബിൾ ബേസ്ഡ് ഓൺ ദി ആറ്റോമിക് മാസസ്. പക്ഷെ ഒരു മെയിൻ മേജർ ഡിഫറൻസ് നമ്മൾ ഇന്ന് കാണുന്ന പീരിയോഡിക് ടേബിളിലും മെന്റലി പീരിയോഡിക് ടേബിളിലും ഉള്ള മെയിൻ ഡിഫറൻസ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് നമ്മുടെ പ്രസന്റ് പീരിയോഡിക് ടേബിൾ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് അറേഞ്ച്ഡ് ഓൺ ദി ബേസ്ഡ് ഓഫ് ആറ്റോമിക് നമ്പർ അല്ലെ. ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് അറേഞ്ച്ഡ് അക്കോർഡിംഗ് ടു ദ ഇൻക്രീസിംഗ് ഓർഡർ ഓഫ് ആറ്റോമിക് നമ്പർ. ബട്ട് മെന്റലിന്റെ പീരിയോഡിക് ടേബിൾ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഇറ്റ് വാസ് ബേസ്ഡ് ഓൺ ആറ്റോമിക് മാസ്. But elements of similar mass and character are difficult to distinguish. Mendeleev was in correspondence with Julia Lermontova, a Russian scientist working in Heidelberg and the first woman to obtain a doctorate in chemistry. Okay, so her work on separation, പക്ഷേ നമ്മൾ അധികം ഡിസ്കസ് ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ ഹിസ്റ്ററിയിൽ കൂടുതലായിട്ട് മെന്റലീവിന്റെ പേരേ പറയുന്നുള്ളൂ. ഈ ഒരു പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ വുമന്റെ പേര്, ജൂലിയയുടെ പേര് അധികം മെൻഷൻ ചെയ്ത് കണ്ടിട്ടില്ല. ഓക്കെ, ബട്ട് നൗ ഓൾ ആർ റീകളക്ടിങ് ദ പാർട്ടിസിപ്പേഷൻ ഓഫ് വുമൺ ഓൾസോ. ഓക്കെ, ഹർ വർക്ക് ഓൺ സെപ്പറേഷൻ മെത്തേഡ്സ് പ്ലാറ്റിനം ഗ്രൂപ്പ് ഓഫ് എലമെന്റ്സ് മെൻ ദാറ്റ് എലമെന്റ് കുഡ് ബി പ്രോബബ്ലി പ്ലേസ്ഡ് ഇൻ ദ പീരിയോഡിക് ടേബിൾ. And the success of Mendeleev's periodic table was mainly due to him leaving gaps in the table for the further possible elements. So that Mendeleev periodic table build cheyumba thanne kore gaps undayirunnu periodic table la. That's for the elements which has to be discovered later alle. Ini vella elements later la inventions vanninjal adinu gaps ittittayirunnu Mendeleev's discovery. Okay, so the many women have been involved in the search of new elements. Marie Curie discovered radium and polonium in 1890s and was the first woman to be awarded a Nobel Prize. Other notable women involved in the discovery of element in the last century include Lise Meitner, that is protactinium in 1917, and Ida Noddack, rhenium in 1925, and Margaret Perret, francium in 1939. So most of these women worked with the male collaborators and their contribution were not always fully acknowledged at that time. അല്ലെ, ഇന്ന് കാണുന്ന അത്ര അക്നോളജ്മെന്റ് ആ ഒരു പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ സെഞ്ചുറിയിൽ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നില്ല. സോ ഫ്രാൻസിയം വാസ് ദ ഫസ്റ്റ് ലാസ്റ്റ് എലമെന്റ് ടു ബി ഡിസ്കവേർഡ് ഇൻ ദ നേച്ചർ ആൻഡ് ദ സെർച്ച് ഫോർ ദ ന്യൂ എലമെന്റ്സ് നൗ റിക്വയേഴ്സ് ലാർജ് ടീംസ് വിത്ത് പാർട്ടിക്കുൽ എക്സ്പ്ലോറേറ്റേഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് ബിഗ് ബഡ്ജറ്റ്സ്. സോ ദ വർക്ക് ബൈ അമേരിക്കൻ കെമിസ്റ്റ് ഡാലിയ ഹോഫ്മാൻ ആൻഡ് ഡോൺ Chegnuzzi helped to discover the most recent six new super heavy elements, that is element 113 to 118. They were officially recognized in 2015 and Clarice Forbes, one of the co-discoverers of tenazine, that is a particular lady, that is Clarice, is the first African American woman to discover a new chemical element. So the critical of role of woman, she is Clarice who discovered, she's a co-discoverer of tenazine. Okay, the critical role of woman in the science has been recognized by UNESCO. In 2015, UNESCO established the International Day of Women and Girls in Science and celebrated annually 11 February on an opportunity to promote the access and participation in science for women and girls. So the question is, why do you think that much of early pioneering work by women scientists was not acknowledged at the time? Alle anna aa time la oru particular period of time la acknowledgement illa. Innundo innaanengil nammal koodalayittu science field ayirunnengil edoru research field edukkaanengilum male prominence, adhu edhu field eduthalum male prominence aanu koodal. But we can see the change alla oru pandathe oru irayna nokumbam there is a huge change for job opportunities anengilum both men and women equal opportunity kodukkunnund. But acknowledgement men scientists and aduthu athre women scientists nu kittunu ennallathu innum oru question thanneyanu. So this is a part nammada endha varu theoryko nammal padikkan povunnathu vendalla, but it's a fact that we have to give equal importance for the women scientists also. Okay, so our next discussion is about classifying elements. We have already discussed about periods and groups in the periodic table, right? So the groups are the vertical columns in the periodic table. So all modern version of periodic table are based on the table proposed by the Mendeleev in 1816-19. We have discussed some aspects of the periodic table when describing atomic structure in the chapter 2. So an example of periodic table is given in figure 13.2. So here we can see a periodic table. So in the periodic table, we can see main 8 group elements, that is group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4, group 5, group 6, group 7 and group 8. And we have discussed that the electrons in the outermost shells, that is valence electrons, will give you the group number which the particular element belongs. If the valence electron is 6, that is if the outermost shell electron is containing 6 electron, means it is belonging to the group 6. Okay. So here in the periodic table, we can see that different colors. So oro colorum indicate another oro particular group of elements are. Here we can see on the left side, just metals, that is reactive metals, and oro group in oro name in the. So group 1 elements are known as alkaline metals and group 2 metals are known as alkaline earth metals. So group 1 metals are known as what? Alkaline metals, and group 2 elements are metals are known as alkaline earth metals. And in between ee kaanuna ee blue shade illa ella idinim transition elements naana parayunnathu. So group 3 is known as the boron family. This group 6 is known as carbon family. Group 5 is known as nitrogen family. Group 6 is known as oxygen family. Group 7 is known as halogens. Halogens. And group 8 is known as noble gas, inert gas. Okay. So group 1, alkaline metals. Group 2, alkaline earth metals. Group 3, boron family. Group 6, carbon family. Group 5, nitrogen family. Group 6, oxygen family. Group 7, halogens. And group 8, they are known as noble gas, inert gas. In any color discuss here. So either group 1 and group 2 metals and reactive elements are that is alkali metals and alkaline earth metals. Okay. Next is green shade. E can in a green shade is less reactive metals are, that is aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium, lead, bismuth. Idaka less reactive metals are. Pinna e can in a yellow shade lulla non-metals are, they include group 7 halogens. In the color indicate in the sky blue shade transition elements are, they are hard, strong and dense metals. In the brown shade metalloids are, that is semiconductors. That is metal transition non-metal in between stage we can call it as metalloids. They are semiconductors. Silicon germanium okay an example. Last which is known as noble gas, they are completely stable and very unreactive. So in the periodic table, elements are arranged in the increasing order of the atomic number. Across the period, we can say they are arranged in the increasing order. So here we can see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Appa ingane oru increasing order laana elements arrange cheyidirikkunnathu. And the vertical columns of the elements with the similar properties are called groups. Okay, the vertical columns are known as groups and they all have similar properties. Oru groupilulla ella elements, oru groupilulla all elements will be having similar properties. So next we are going to discuss about metals and non-metals. The main distinction in the periodic table is between metals and non-metals. So metals are clearly separated from non-metals. This is metals, this section is metal and this section is non-metal. So metals and non-metals are clearly separated in the periodic table. And the non-metals are grouped into top right hand region of the periodic table above thick separated line of sample of hafnium. And we know that from the looking at the periodic table, that is a metal, that is here, although we may never have seen a sample of element hafnium, we know from looking at the periodic table, it is a metal. So, we are discussing the metals and non-metals and separate the and one of the first use of periodic table we can analyze our elements in the. Although we may never seen in a sample of element hafnium, we know that look at the periodic table, that is a metal. Alle, hafnium, periodic table analyze hafnium it's a metal because the transition elements. So the metal.
So we may also be able to predict the sum of its properties. So the transition metals in a core similar properties and so upper our particular group will put in the property in paranite. Okay, so the change from the metallic to non-metallic properties in the element across the period is not a clear cut suggested by drawing line between two regions of the periodic table. So the namkariam even across the period edutha, there is a change from metal to non-metal. Like metal in the non-metal or a drastic change in the so the change from metal to non-metal properties in the element across the across a period is not clear-cut suggested by drawing line between two regions of the periodic table. The element close to the line show the properties in, that lie between two extremes. So, let's say, if we have metals and non-metals, this line in the section, it is an extreme. Metals in the non-metals in the rendering properties. Okay? So, these elements are now offered as metalloids. So, that's what we call semiconductors or metalloids or semi-metals. Such elements have some of the properties of metals and other have no, that have more characteristics of non-metals. So, there are characters. There are eight elements that are metalloids. ഏതൊക്കെയാ മെറ്റലോയിഡ്സ് നമ്മൾ ഇവിടെ മെറ്റലോയിഡ്സ് പറയുന്നുണ്ടല്ലോ ഏതാ ബോറോൺ സിലിക്കൺ ജെർമാനിയം ആർസെനിക് ആന്റിമണി ടാലിയം പൊളോണിയം ആൻഡ് ഹിയർ വി കൻ അസറ്റാറ്റൺ ലൈമോട്ടിയം പിന്നെ ടെറസിൻ സോ ഇത്രയും ആണ് മെറ്റലോയിഡ്സ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഓക്കെ So there are eight elements that are called metalloids. They often look like metals but also brittle like a non-metal. They are neither conductor or nor insulator. But make excellent semiconductors. The prime examples of this type of element is silica. So silicon, that is silicon another example. The periodic table allows to make more useful subdivisions of elements that simply deciding which are metals and which are non-metals. The elements present in group 1 to 8 of the periodic table are sometimes known as main group elements. That is, this 1 to 8 are the main group elements. Because in this area, we have a Korea section. So, that is the main group. That is the transition. That is the section of transition element. That is the metals and the non-metals. That is the transition within the section. That is the transition elements ennu parayunnathu okay appo ee baakiyulla ellathine nammal endha paraya main group element so those vertical groups are show most clearly how elements within the same group have same chemical and physical properties adhaidhu oru groupilulla oru element alkaline metals aanengil adine ellathinum egadesham same physical and chemical properties aayirikkum undava adhe pole ipo halogen family edutha adilum adhe pole thanne aayirikkum so some of these group have particular name as well as numbers and we will refer refer to this name later in the chapter. So between group 1 and 2, 1 and 2 and 3, between group 2 and 3 of these main group, group 2 kanya, group 3 vela. So idin edilori section unda. So that section is known as transition elements. Okay. So some of these group have that is between group 1 and 2 of the main group element is block of element known as transition elements. Okay, what is a transmission element? Elements from the central region of the periodic table. They are hard, strong, dense metals which form compounds that are often colored. What are transition elements? That is in the central region of the periodic table. They are very hard, strong and dense metal. Which compounds? That is the speciality. These metals are compound to compare in the colored compounds. Okay. And what is main group elements? Elements in the outer groups of the periodic table, excluding transition metal. Transition elements excluding the group in the main group elements. And the first row of these elements occur in period 4. Your transition element evadana period 4 lana in the first row to then. Okay. So the noble gas in group A, that is E transition metal, that is the important item the metals are iron, copper and zinc. Noble gas in group 8 on the right hand side of the periodic table are the least reactive elements because they are complete, they have 8 electrons in the outermost shell, so they are noble electrons. So, stable gases allengil stable electronic arrangement ennu namukku parayan pattum. And however, the group next to the group 7, which are known as halogens, the group on the left hand side of the periodic table, that is group 1 or alkali metals, are the most reactive elements alle. Adayith ipo namukku ee oru section nokumbo oru periodic table la nokumbo nammal paranju group 7 ennu parayunnathu on the right, group 8 on the periodic table is noble gas, so the least reactive elements aanu. However, the group next to them, group 7 allengi halogens, and the group on the left hand side of the periodic table are group 1 alkali metals are the most reactive elements. Adayith ee group undallo group 1 um group 7 um aanu ee periodic table de most reactive elements. Ee group 1 elements ennu parayunnathu most reactive metals um group 7 ennu parayunnathu most reactive non metals. Adinte reason endha nu vechina namukku ariyam lithiyathinte outermost shell-il etra electrons undu, 1 electron aanu ullathu. Appo sodium eduthalum 1 aanu, potassium eduthalum 1 aanu, because it belongs to first group. So njan valency ennu parayunna oru term parayundayirunnu, the number of electrons it may donate or accept to make a stable electronic configuration, octet electronic configuration create cheyanayittu the number of electrons an atom will donate or accept. So here the number of electrons donated by sodium, potassium, lithium ellam 1 aanu. In the case appo it can easily donate, appo easily donate 1 ku easy aayittu donate cheyan pattunnathu kondu adinte reactivity endayirikkum koodalayirikkum. In the case of group 7, adinte valence electron ennu parayunnathu ellathinum 7 aanu, because 7th group aavumbo valence electron 7 aanu. Valency ethraya 1 aanu. Ivada 1 donate cheyum, ivada 1 accept cheyum, because ipo fluorine edukkaanengil namukku ariyam 2 7 aanu atomic number. So by accepting 1 electron it will be having 8 electrons in the outermost shell alle. Adayith fluorine electronic configuration 2 7 aanu. So by accepting 1 electron its electronic configuration will become easily become 2 8. So it can accept 1 electron. Inipo e side eduthinga lithiyathinte aanengil 2 1 aanu. So by donating 2 electron it will become stable. First shell 2 mari, inipo sodium edukkaanengil 2 8 1 aanu. So it can easily donate 1 electron and it can become 2 8. So appo ivada here this side is donating electron and this side is accepting electron alle, ullilote electrons accept cheyana. So ivada 1 electron vaanga easy aayittu kodukum cheyan, adhe pole 1 electron easy aayittu vaangum cheyam. So appo adinte reactivity endayirikkum, reactivity will be more for group 1 and group 7 elements. Okay, reactivity will more for group 1 and group 7 elements. Okay, and the noble gas in group adu nammal discuss edu next appo ithrayum karyangala nammal innu discuss edu endakya padichathu periodic table de arrangement adayith reactive metals evadeyanu non reactive non metals reactive metals padichu adey pole reactive non metals evadeyanu nu padichu and transition elements evadeyanu main group elements edana adey pole thanne nammal metalloids ne kurichu padichu and position. So ini kore karyangal in the introduction bhage kaiyittu, so ee lesson nannayi vaikka chapter 13. So if you have any doubt you can message me children. Thank you.